The cursed position of Defense Against the Dark Arts is one of the most recognized plot points in the Harry Potter book series. Teaching this class was perhaps second only to being the Hogwarts High Inquisitor as a career killer. But was putting a jinx on the position really a good idea on Voldemort's part? Did the curse actually help cause his downfall? Join us as we explore these questions in this video. How did the curse come to existence? With a different DADA teacher in each of the seven Harry Potter books, it's no wonder why everyone believed the position was cursed. And Dumbledore confirmed in the sixth book of the series that the Dark Lord was behind it all.
"Oh, he definitely wanted the Defense Against the Dark Arts job," said Dumbledore. "The aftermath of our little meeting proved that. You see, we have never been able to keep a Defense Against the Dark Arts teacher for longer than a year. Since I refused the post to Lord Voldemort."
Dumbledore, Chapter 20, Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince. When Tom Riddle graduated, he applied to become a professor at DADA, but was rejected by Headmaster Armando Dippet because he was too young. He returned to Hogwarts 2 decades later and reapplied for the position, but Albus Dumbledore denied him again. Enraged, the Dark Lord then put a jinx on the post, and no professor has ever held that position for more than 1 year. That is, until he was defeated once and for all. He may have cursed the position, thinking it would help him advance his dark plans. That came to be true during the First Wizarding War, as the lack of a long-term defense against the dark arts teacher could have stunted the quality of Hogwarts students. However, it did not help him much during Harry's time at Hogwarts. Voldemort had 4 of his Death Eaters as professors of defense against the dark arts, and none of them could stay in the position for longer than a year and further his goals. Here are the unfortunate souls on Voldemort's side who fell victim to the curse. Quirinus Quirrell. Quirrell took over the position during Harry's first year at Hogwarts. He was a Muggle Studies professor before he took this job. Quirrell stumbled upon Voldemort's shadow in the jungles of Albania. However, Voldemort quickly took over his body and turned him into a loyal follower.
"Then, 4 years ago, the means for my return seemed assured. A wizard, young, foolish, and gullible, wandered across my path in the forest I had made my home. Oh, he seemed the very chance I had been dreaming of, for he was a teacher at Dumbledore's school. He was easy to bend to my will. He brought me back to this country, and after a while, I took possession of his body to supervise him closely as he carried out my orders. But my plan failed. I did not manage to steal the Philosopher's Stone. I was not to be assured immortal life. I was thwarted once again by Harry Potter."
Lord Voldemort, Chapter 33, Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. Unfortunately for Voldemort, but lucky for Harry and the team, Quirrell ended up dead after experiencing excruciating pain from Harry Potter's love protection at the end of Book 1. Voldemort's fragmented soul had to flee, and he had to wait 4 more years to regain his body. This was the first time Voldemort's jinx on DADA derailed his plans. Barty Crouch Jr. Barty Crouch Jr. was one of the most accomplished followers of Voldemort. It was he who disguised himself as Alistair Mad-Eye Moody, the new Defense Against the Dark Arts professor at Hogwarts during Harry's 4th year. He turned the Triwizard Cup into a portkey, which transported Harry Potter and Cedric Diggory to Voldemort, engineering the events that resulted in the Dark Lord's return. Unfortunately, he got caught soon after and received a Dementor's kiss. While he did manage to send Harry to Voldemort for the ritual, he could not save himself. As a result, Voldemort lost one of his most significant assets. This was the second time the curse on DADA worked against Voldemort. Severus Snape. The Potions Master of Hogwarts took over DADA position during the 6th book. Snape was a double agent, but Voldemort believed him to be on his side. And yet, the curse on the position did not leave him alone. Even Harry knew that Snape would be gone next year.
"Well, there's one good thing," he said savagely. "Snape will be gone by the end of the year."
"What do you mean?" asked Ron.
"That job's jinxed. No one lasted more than a year. Quirrell actually died doing it. Personally, I'm going to keep my fingers crossed for another death."
Harry, Chapter 8, Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince. Snape's tenure at Hogwarts was extremely valuable to the Dark Lord, and yet Snape had to flee Hogwarts after killing Albus Dumbledore, forcing him to give up the post. It was another setback in Voldemort's plans. Amicus Carrow. During the last book of the Harry Potter series, Voldemort and his followers took over Hogwarts. They changed the subject from Defense Against the Dark Arts to just Dark Arts. But that did not save Amicus Crow from the Jinx. Even though he was a full-grown wizard with decades of experience, Harry incapacitated him with the Cruciatus Curse before the Battle of Hogwarts. He was likely sent to Azkaban for life for his crimes as a Death Eater after Voldemort's death.
Unless you subscribe to the channel now, you might find yourself on the way to Azkaban as well.
Just kidding. But feel free to subscribe all the same. My final thoughts on the curse. Voldemort's curse on this position meant Hogwarts had to change over 40 Defense Against Dark Arts teachers from 1957 to 1998. He might have had no control over it, as his four Death Eaters suffered the consequences of the Jinx, which prevented him from getting his plans into action. So, do you agree with us? Did cursing the DADA position help him further his goals? Or was it just a hurdle in his plans? We would love to hear your thoughts, so let us know in the comment section below. Strangely, none of these were the worst teacher that Hogwarts had. Click the video on screen to see who was actually worse.